a very significant increase in those pages usually means that you probably have been hacked. This is very often a very easy way to see whether you have been hacked. You see a huge increase in those crawled currently not indexed. You see the URLs that never existed really on your website, like very often some e-commerce terms or even like some Viagra terms, all sorts of things.
Subscribe to access Olga's almost 15 years of experience in SEO and download your SEO growth kit at seosly.io. SEO Sly, elite level SEO by Olga Czar.
Google Search Console in its indexing report shows you what pages are indexed and what pages aren't indexed. And in the case of pages which aren't indexed, you will see this report that lists the number of pages and a specific reason why the page isn't indexed. And a very popular reason is crawled currently not indexed. So in my case, this is here, crawled currently not indexed. So what does it mean? Is it a problem? So crawled currently not indexed, as the name suggests, simply means that Google crawled a specific URL, but decided not to index it for now. Why it is happening can be caused by a lot of reasons. It can be a reason to be worried, but it can also be something that you can easily ignore. When you see that report, first thing you should look at is the trend. Are you seeing like a ton of new pages appearing, like you had 3 pages and now you have 3 million pages? If this is the case, a very significant increase in those pages usually means that you probably have been hacked. In the case of WordPress websites, this is very often a very easy way to see whether you have been hacked. You see a huge increase in those crawled currently not indexed, and here you see the URLs that never existed really on your website, like very often some e-commerce terms or even like some Viagra terms, all sorts of things, things that you never had on your website, at least things you never put on your website. Google very often very quickly sees that these aren't really the pages you wanted to put, and Google is very intelligent in that respect. That usually, but of course it depends, it starts to ignore those URLs and they simply get listed here or under discovered, currently not indexed, which means that Google didn't even crawl those pages. Hacking is one of the reasons. Trend, you want to look at trend. And the next thing, obviously, is you want to see the sample of those URLs. Google is giving you some examples here. All you need to do is basically review them and decide whether this is a URL that really is important, should be indexed, or whether those URLs are okay to be here. So in the case of my website, I can see here, I think this is an affiliate link. Here I can see some images, some RSS feeds. So it doesn't look like I have here pages that I should be worried about. But here I see, for example, this one, Yandex Search Operators. This is quite recent, so I click on it. And the next thing to do is actually check whether this issue still exists, because very often what you see in Google Search Console is outdated or existed for a moment and now is no longer the case. So if you see the URLs here that you think should be indexed but aren't, then you need to verify whether this is still true. So let's say this one. I can here click just inspect and inspect it, and I actually see that URL is not on Google. So what do I do now? I click here and I see this is redirect error. So this specific URL, from what I remember, is simply redirected to, I think, something with a blog. So as you can see here, this is just redirected. So it is okay for this URL to be first in the crawled currently not indexed bucket, and second, to not be indexed by Google, because this URL is basically non-indexable because it is redirected. So page fetch failed, redirect error. So everything is okay, even though Google is screaming error, not indexed, and all of that. So you don't always need to be really worried about those URLs. The most important thing for you is to review them and actually confirm. And once you actually see a URL that should be here and it isn't here, and you have validated that, yeah, actually this URL should be indexed, this URL is okay, but Google somehow doesn't want to index that, then you should think about the quality. Maybe there is something to do with quality. I've seen a lot of websites which create a ton of content with AI, and this content is like really poor quality. Very often, most of those pages, their entire website can get stuck in this place. And then the thing to do is to work on quality of those pages and so on and so on, so that Google thinks that, yeah, now those pages actually deserve to be ranked, because Google is overloaded with like billions, I don't know how many new websites which create content at scale with AI and want to be indexed. So Google, I think Google's filtering sort of in this respect has become stricter and stricter because its indexed is huge, but it is limited, right? And the amount of content that used to be created and is created now, I think makes it even necessary for Google to be more restrictive. I also have this guide if you want to look at that in the written form, which basically explains what I just said. And you can just follow the steps to confirm and the things you should do. If you want to bulk check those specific indexing issues, you can crawl the website with, for example, Screaming Frog using Google Search Console API. Then Screaming Frog will check the status, will inspect those URLs in bulk and then report it back to you. You just need to remember that there is a limit of, I think, 2,000 URLs per day. So that's a guide I might recommend you also take a look at. Types of pages that can also get here and which are okay to be here are the ones I showed you, like feed URLs, some weird like images, which may even be like, there are like a few images and I have thousands of images, so not a problem. I'm not even looking at that. So filtered URLs, usually. It also depends on the setup of your website, but usually they should be here. Tag pages, in some cases category pages, especially if they're like empty, Google will very often put them here. Some archives, some paginated pages, but it depends on the type of website you have and whether you want paginated pages to be indexed, crawled. So we are getting now into this, it depends, territory. RSS feeds, XML sitemaps, you don't want Google to index your XML sitemaps. You just want Google to crawl them and discover URLs you have them. And of course, hacked spammy pages will be in that bucket. I've also seen a ton of examples of websites where you had like millions of pages here in discovered, currently not indexed, but you also had millions of indexed pages here where this attack, this hack was so strong that Google indexed a ton of those pages. And it was difficult to get rid of those pages from the index. And in such cases, usually the quickest way is, of course, to restore the website from this hack and then return status code 410, which means gone, so that Google can more quickly get rid of them. Because if you return 404, Google may keep coming back to those pages for years. And Google likes to keep looking at removed 404 pages or even for pages you never had on your website. But that's a different story. Is there something else I want to tell you? I think, yeah, I recommend you check a look at this guide. You always review those URLs. Whether you validate that or you don't, it doesn't really matter. If you see a URL that you think actually should be, as I said, should be indexed, one thing you can also do, you can simply like add a site, then type the URL and see if it pops up. If it doesn't pop up, then it isn't indexed. Sometimes you may see something here that actually is indexed, but the information you have here is simply outdated. So keep an eye on this, but just because you have pages here doesn't mean there are like issues with your website. Every website, I think, on the internet has something in crawled currently not indexed. And this doesn't mean that this website actually has a problem. It just means that the page was crawled by Google, but not indexed. And it may or may not be indexed in the future. So according to Google, there is no need to resubmit this URL for crawling. Based on my experience, it may help to resubmit a specific URL, but again, it depends. If you keep resubmitting an empty URL, like with no content, probably you won't be successful. But if you have a newer website, and this is actually a good article, it may sometimes speed up indexing. So that's it. I invite you to subscribe to my newsletter, seoslide.io, where I send a lot of tips about SEO. Of course, subscribe to my channel and comment. Let me know what struggles you have had with crawls currently not indexed. Like, what crazy things have you seen there? And I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Download your SEO growth kit, $999 worth, at seoslide.io.